Ozzy DeVos. Billionaire, right-wing political activist, and notorious cum guzzler. But before we get to the amazing... Yes, if there's one thing you can count on with Betsy DeVos is that she's going to enforce her right-wing religious agenda on all of America, whether they like it or not, and she's going to guzzle gallons of semen. But before we get to the amazing story of Betsy DeVos and her cum-guzzling adventures, I feel that a little history lesson is in order. We must properly set the scene to learn about how Betsy became a blown-out cum addict. You need to understand the town she comes from, Holland, Michigan.
Oh, Mr. Happy Pants, nobody cares about Holland. They just want to see me guzzle cum, right, everybody?
Yes, but first, Holland, Michigan is kind of an every town USA. Kind of like your town, Grand Rapids. Everyone's white, middle class. They got conservative family values. And they're repressed as fuck. Holland is a whitewashed community that likes to present itself as a safe place to live, safe place to raise your kids in. But behind closed doors, it's kind of a different story. Let's do a song about Holland, Michigan.
Vander Oosten. That's
from me because I spend all my time masturbating and thinking about your son.
That was a joke about how long Dutch names are, and also about the real problem of sexual repression, and that it's real and present in our society, and white people should just chill out about sex and be natural and not hold it in.
Yeah,
and let
man.
It pervert into drastic
be
dark
natural.
Fetishes
be
that
natural.
Sometimes get out of hand. Church
and beat our wives
and commit rape
and masturbate.
Masturbate is different from raping. I just want to say
not in Holland.
Okay.
I've got to get with the times.
But we're assured by one simple fact.
At least we are red black.
Yes, Betsy DeVos is from Holland, Michigan. But back then, she was Elizabeth Prince, the daughter of Edgar Prince. You can't get more Midwestern, more American than Edgar Prince. A true rags-to-riches story, Edgar Prince became a billionaire almost overnight off of selling needless products that only white trash West Michigan hillbillies would buy, like lighted sun visors for cars.
This is my daughter. I taught her how to gargle cum. I taught her how to gargle cum.
Yes, yes. A true right-wing wacko, Edgar Prince was the nation's largest private donor to the religious right. Edgar Prince hated gays, sex, brown people.
Less talking, more man-milk guzzling.
Joy, laughter. Edgar Prince is the guy behind a little group called the Family Research Council. If you haven't heard of it, the FRC was classified as a hate group in 2010 by the Southern Poverty Law Firm due to its strident policies against homosexuality, gay rights, divorce, and pornography. The FRC is a pretty fucked up organization. Its most recent director, Josh Duggar, of the show 40 Million Kids and Counting, he stepped down and resigned when it came out that he had molested 4 underage girls. Yeah, Edgar Prince is one seriously sexually repressed dude. Let's hear from Edgar now.
Nobody should have sex or touch a boob or put a dick in a butt. Nobody should look at naked bodies, especially the penis, or put a dick in a butt. Brown people, they can't be trusted.
Just not gay if it's incest. It's also not rape if it's murder.
What?
It's not rape if it's murder. It's not murder if it's rape. If you're caught fucking corpse, you say because you already ate. I swear I'm
okay.
You learn something new every day. Anyway, Edgar Prince died in the 90s when he fell down a flight of stairs.
Whoop! Oh my God!
Oh, Daddy! Missing her father. Missing her father, Betsy would often drink all the gallons of his semen that was rotting in her brother's asshole and think about him.
That's my daddy!
My daddy.
She would drink her father's semen, her dead father's semen, out of her asshole.
That's what I'm doing, you fucker!
And think about him. Now, we've already met him. But when talking about Betsy DeVos, one must put her brother, Eric Prince, in the same sentence. Eric is the guy who's gonna send a mercenary army to kill me after he hears about this production.
I'm also the state champion Blue Ribbon Jizz Swisher.
Eric Prince is the guy behind a little army for hire called Blackwater that may or may not have committed some of the worst atrocities of the Iraq War in the 90s and is currently under some pretty freaking scary federal investigations.
And I also like romantic comedies, macrame, walks on the beach, and going down to the vets home and have World War II era belly gunners jizz in my face.
Yeah, Edgar Prince is just another average Midwestern boy intent on pushing his right-wing religious agenda on all of America, whether they like it or not. Let's hear from Eric Prince now.
Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill. Kill you dead. Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill. Kill you dead. Brown, brown, brown. Brown, brown, brown.
What have you been up to today?
Oh, well, you know, killing some brown people and stealing their resources. Maybe a little election rigging on the side.
Oh, little brother. I'm so proud of you. You're always doing God's good work on this earth.
Why, yes, I am such a good boy.
Such a good boy.
I'm a little good boy. Good boy. Boy, I'm a little good, good boy, good. Put the sandwich in my belly. Put the sandwich in my belly. Put the sandwich in my belly. Good boy, good. Semen out of my asshole enough to get you through the rest of the musical segment?
No, I want to gargle come right now, and this time I want it fancy.
But we're billionaires. We do everything fancy.
Yes. Let's show these lower class audience members the proper way to drink semen.
The way smart and superior people do.
Yes. Yes. They make me sick, actually. Thank you. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Thank you. Yes.
Hurry up.
Poor semen is best enjoyed from a glass, particularly wanted to make sure you know, day old horse come. Cheers, my little brother.
Cheers. It's only just now hitting me that we did this five nights around the country for a month.
Shut up or I'll kill your family.
How's it taste?
It's like chocolate and strawberries.
With a hint of the stable.
That's Joe's eccentric billionaire laugh.
I'll kill your fucking families. All of you. Fuck you.
Betsy DeVos is a big advocate of charter schools. And I wrote a song about charter schools for the show, but I deemed it too boring, so let's skip that.
It was terrible.
And get to why Elizabeth Prince became Betsy DeVos. I love it that I'm explaining it to all you. I had to explain it to everyone else on the road. We all know, but I'll stick to the script. In a true dynastic style marriage, Betsy was arranged to be married to Dick DeVos of the Amway fortune. If you don't know what Amway is, it's the world's largest multi-level, multinational marketing scheme. A true pyramid scheme, Dick DeVos is like a cult leader who swindled millions of people out of billions of dollars with false promises that if they buy his soap or vitamins or laundry detergent, they'll get rich like he does. But he just really operates a Scientology-like cult that when you sign up for it, you gotta buy their books, DVDs, CDs, magazines, go to the seminars. Yes, Dick DeVos is the world's greatest snake oil salesman.
Around this world I've traveled
looky there. There grows up another one. Another one's gonna carry my seed. Well, I say, looky there. There grows up another one. Another one's gonna carry my seed. Well, hey, hey, hey. There grows up another one. Another one gonna carry my seed. Step right up, ladies and gentlemen, and get a taste of what I've got to offer. All around this world I traveled, everywhere I've been. All around this world they are a drinking from my feet. Everyone's gonna come downtown and praise and worship me, because they are a drinking from my feet. Mama and a daddy, they are drinking from my feet. Sister and a brother, they are drinking from my feet. I'm gonna fill you up with exactly what you need. They are a drinking from my feet.
That's right. Gentlemen, are you feeling tired? Are you feeling weak? Are you feeling lost? Are you feeling misunderstood? Well, I have a way out for you. I have the answer. I can pull yourself out of the pit. You can pull yourself out of the darkness. You just gotta do one thing. You gotta spend your money. You gotta spend your money on us. You gotta make us stinking, filthy rich, so we can have all the fun you dream of having at your expense. You gotta let us fuck and suck and fuck and suck and fuck and suck and fuck and suck and
ah! Oh, I can't believe myself. They are drinking from my feet. Oh, I can't believe myself. They are drinking from my feet. Mama and a daddy, they are drinking from my feet. Sister and a brother, they are drinking from my feet. On your mouth. Woo! That was tiring. God damn, it's tiring. Tricking millions of people out of their money every day. I get so tired. You know what? Yesterday, I didn't even have time to jack off into a horse's mouth and then drink my own semen from that horse's mouth.
Speaking of jacking off, let's drink some semen out of the severed head of one of our dead Cambodian slave boys.
Yes!
Thank you.
Semen is always best drunk from the rotting skulls of our slaves.
Yes. The lower class just doesn't understand our style and our class. They don't understand that when a person or a society dies at the result of our wealth, it's just Jesus giving us a high five.
That's right, Betsy. They don't like us because we're rich. But Jesus likes us. That's why he made us rich and you poor fucks poor. Think about it. Think about it. You're sitting around watching a show about jizz gobblers, just hoping, hoping if you hold on for just a moment, he might see his tip.
That's true. I just don't understand it. Why don't they like us?
Why don't they like us? Why don't they appreciate all the things that we've done for them? It makes no sense why they don't like xenophobic Dutch conservative billionaires that use vast sums of money to have power and influence over them.
When I lobby for theocracy to put God in business and schools and advocate for gay conversion therapy, my money to bypass the rules.
I just don't understand why they want to live their lives in their own way when we clearly know that that's the way, because we're successful and they're not.
So when I'm feeling sad and confused, I turn to my husband, who knows that I love and cherish him, and we go to
not pull out a 5 foot long syringe.
We cram it up our buttholes and fill it with semen and blood.
And like a mama bird, feed to our children
who will never let go to public school. We'll never let them go to public school. We'll never let them go to public school. We'll never let them go.
Betsy? There's a grizzly bear!
Shoot him, Betsy! Shoot him! Shoot him!
Joe, you should do that on stage because we're taping this for the DVD and you were on the floor. So, Joe, do your entrance again. Yeah, but this is on tape now, so enter from over there. Let's do that again. You guys, it's fine. Yeah, let's take it from, oh, look, it's a grizzly bear. Enter from over there, Joe. This is for the DVD. It's fine. Just go over there.
We'll fix it in post.
Yeah, we'll fix it in post. You guys will find it funny the second time, right? Okay. So, Joe, go over there, stage left, and act like a bear.
Act like a bear. Don't see you.
And then Dick DeVos. No, you're out here already, Joe. You're out here. And Dick DeVos says,
oh, look, Betsy. There's a grizzly bear. Shoot him.
And now I say, thank God we had guns in public schools to stave off those grizzly bear attacks.
To public schools.
Joe, did you break yourself? The best night was when he forgot. We were in New Bedford, Massachusetts, and he forgot his costume, so he came out dressed like a bear, like he came out in leather.
Hey, shut up, you guys! Hold it right there, you blown-out cum guzzlers! That's right, this is a revolution! An uprising! We're sick of doing all the work while you get all the jizz!
Yeah, we've been reading websites like Daily KOS and Democracy Now!, and now we get it thanks to the hard work of all those liberal bastions of truth. You're working us to the bone and you're hogging all the wealth and power!
Workers unite, reject authority! Workers unite, reject authority!
Oh my God, they've been listening to Bernie Sanders! What are we gonna do?
I'm sick of all these rich folks with their semen at the top! They hog it all! There's none for us! We barely get a drop!
They say it trickles down, they say that we'll all get our share, but by the time it makes it down to us, there's barely any there!
We want semen too! We want semen too!
They get all the creamy stuff, and what we get is barely dust. Our meager portion's not enough. They break our backs and fill their cups!
The lazy wealthy sit and rule, and they get all the penis drool. The 1% in their heated pools, they play us like a bunch of fools.
We want semen too! We want semen too!
Ha! We don't care about the government's time! We don't care about the government's time! We don't believe in the government's lie! We want semen too!
Come, you can't. can't handle all this scum. Your life's a mess, you breed disorder. The wealthy keep the world order.
Left to yourself, you rape and kill. You fight and argue, yet you still think you can handle all this krill. You're worse than us, you make me ill. No Steven for you. No Steven for you.
Ha!
We want Steven too.
Ha! We don't care about the government's time. We don't care about the government's time. We don't believe in the government's lie. We want Steven too.
Revolution. That was the sequel to Les Mis, Come Garza.
But next in our tale, last we left the story, the plebeians had revolted, and they were revolting with their gender binary penis and boobs. And all hope seemed lost for Betsy DeVos. She had spent billions of dollars trying to transform society and culture and enforce her right-wing agenda, but people were listening to the liberal bias of the media and thinking for themselves. And it seemed that things would not go as planned for the billionaire class. But then something completely unpredictable happened. Something no one even thought about. Something no one expected in our wildest dreams, and yet it happened. Yes, it happened, and we're living in it right now. Donald J. Trump was elected President of the United States of America. It's only slight groans. I guess people are getting used to it. Or maybe they all voted for the bastard. Say! Oh, you suck, you bastard, you crump, you lizard, you suck, you're a bastard, you've got everyone fooled, you don't play by the rules, oh no.
The brown people, keep out the
from a deep dirt pit at the bottom of a hole. All that wants from a deep dark pit at the bottom of the soul.
Yes, Donald. Betsy, will you be my Secretary of Education?
Well, that depends, Donald.
Depends on what, Betsy?
Do you like cum?
Do I like cum? Betsy, I love cum.
Do you like to gargle cum?
Betsy, I love to gargle cum. It's tremendous.
Donald.
Yes, Betsy.
What is your favorite kind of semen?
Betsy, my favorite kind of semen is horse semen.
Mine too.
Oh, Betsy, let's gargle some cum.
Cheers.